James chapter 1. James, a servant of God and of the Lord Jesus Christ, to the 12 tribes which are scattered abroad, greeting. My brethren, count it all joy when you fall into diverse temptations. Now he's going to say here, James is really the best book how to be in this world, to move around in this world, and not to be of this world. And so he's going to celebrate the fact that you're going to be given different types of temptation. It's going to build your patience, your endurance, and your character. That's really what he's getting across here. So I'm going to pause after some of these verses and talk about what he's really trying to teach us here, because I know that he's coming from a place of Proverbs. So he's teaching us the wisdom of Proverbs, with it, especially Proverbs 1 through 9. All right, let that be your companion study. And then he's also going back, we can find mostly in Matthew, where he's going to go back and he's repeating the messages of Jesus. And so that's what James is all about, is back and forth between, identically, the teachings of Jesus with an emphasis on the Sermon on the Mount. So he's going to stick very closely to the teachings that Jesus taught, Sermon on the Mount, and then Proverbs. So as we go through James, we can let those be our, our companion guides, right? Matthew 5, with the Sermon on the Mount. Okay, verse 3. Knowing this, that the trying of your faith works patience, but let patience have her perfect work, that you may be perfect, entire, wanting nothing. If any of you lack wisdom, let him ask of God, that giveth all to men liberally and unbraideth not. In other words, reviled not. Don't let men be your guidance. Go to God, go to the Proverbs, go to the Bible, and it shall be given him. But let him ask in faith, nothing wavering. For he that wavereth is like a wave of the sea driven with the wind and tossed. That reminds you of the chaotic waves that Isaiah prophesied about? For let not that man think that he shall receive anything of the Lord. A double-minded man is unstable in all his ways. Let the brother of low degree rejoice in that he is exalted. James is pointing out your time in this world and your life in this human mortal body is not as important as your eternal, glorified, immortal body, your eternal walk with Father God Jesus. That's really what he's talking about. It's okay. You're going to be poor. You're going to be tempted. You're going to be starving. You're going to have trials and tribulations. Just keep your faith. Never waver from sound doctrine or your faith. And your reward is eternity. That's the message of James and Jesus. First, Jesus. But the rich, in that he is made low, because as the flower of the grass, he shall pass away. From the sun is no sooner risen with a burning heat, but it withereth as the grass, as the flower there fall, and the grace of the fashion of it perish. So also shall the rich man fade away in his ways. Again, there's a lot. Not only James will talk about, he'll go on to talk about the arrogance of wealth and the dangers of wealth. So be careful how we spend, how we treat money. It's really important. We need to be helping others. James 1:12, blessed is the man that endure temptation, for when he is tried, he shall receive the crown of life, which the Lord has promised to them that love him. Beautiful, right there. That's your refrigerator magnet moment right there. If you endure the temptation, God is going to give you a way around that temptation. Paul tells us that, okay? You may be tempted, but there is a way around it. 13, let no man say when he is tempted, I am tempted of God. For God cannot be tempted with evil, neither tempteth he any man. But every man is tempted when he is drawn away of his own lust and enticed. Then when lust hath conceived it, bring forth sin. And sin, when it is finished, bring forth death. Do not err on beloved brethren. See, he's saying right there, it's not worth it. You're going to get death, which is, you know, since death isn't actually real, what he's really saying here is you're going to have eternity in hell away from God. You're going to be separated from God forever. That's really what death is about. Being isolated and separated from God. Can you imagine spending forever isolated, alone and in the dark? And that is part of what hell is. Every good gift, every perfect gift is from above and comes down from the Father of lights. I love that. Father of lights. With whom is no variableness, neither shadow of turning of his own will begat he us with the word of truth, that we should be a kind of first fruits of his creatures. Wherefore, my beloved brethren, let every man be swift to hear and slow to speak, slow to wrath. Solomon in Ecclesiastes will repeat, not verbatim like this, but the same way. Be very slow, but use very little words. I think what Solomon says, use very little words. Just sit and listen, observe, try not to speak too much. That's the wisdom of Solomon. For the wrath of man work not the righteousness of God. Wherefore, lay apart all filthiness and superfluity. Let's look up that word superfluity in the concordance. I don't know if I know what that means. I'm not going to take a guess at it. Oh, of course, my computer's slow to load here. Okay, here we go. Superfluity is the number 4050. It means abundance, superabundantly, superfluously, superiority, preeminence, gain, profit, residue, remains. The wickedness remaining over in a Christian from his state prior to conversion, used by the Greeks to describe the excess wax in their ears. Okay, so now we're clear on that. Superfluity of naughtiness, and receive the meekness, the engrafted word, which is able to save your souls. But be ye doers of the word and not hearers only, deceiving your own selves. In other words, faith in action. James, really, if I were to summarize James, like the whole body of his work here of the letters, is faith in action, truly faith in action. For if any be a hearer of a word and not a doer, he is like unto a man beholding his natural face in a glass. Glass here is a mirror. For he beholdeth himself and goeth his way, straightway forgetteth what manner he was. So he's saying, if you see your brethren cold, hungry, thirsty, starving on the streets, without any money to help him, you know, do something for your brother. Don't just wish him well and be on your way. Stop, listen, comfort, protect, and help in every which way you can. Don't just pass by. Your faith has to be works in action. Faith in action, right? But whoso looketh into the perfect law of liberty and continue therein, he being not a forgetful hearer, but a doer of the work, this man shall be blessed in his deed. If a man among you seem to be religious and bridle not his tongue, but deceiveth his own heart, this man's religion is vain. Pure religion and undefiled before God and the Father is this, to visit the fatherless and widows in their affliction and keep himself unspotted from the world. Right? It's what Jesus teaches us in Matthew 25, right? 35 to 46, and Matthew 7, 20 to 23. And all God's people said, stay in the word.